stays seated. Reason being, we have lots of little boys who might be a little bit. So if you could stay seated, we'd appreciate it until payway comes down the aisle. We'd really appreciate that. Could you please also turn off your mobile phones or at least on the silent? If you could check them out like this. The service has been photographed and filmed to the nth degree, so there's no need to be taking photos during the service. You will have access to them. One of the beautiful things about today is that Peiwei's parents are going to be joining us from Taiwan. We're not able to come because of you know what, but they're going to be joining us. So this is, nothing could go wrong with it. So we are very grateful. The boys will be bringing fabric petals along the aisle, but we don't smoke confetti, etc. When we get out into the field, go for it, but please, if we could just allow the boys to use the petals, that would be great. And can we ask you to not put anything on social media for at least a time before Nathaniel and Peiwei decide to share their day with the rest of the world? So if you could respect that, that would be wonderful. So, I can hear down the back there is much milling around. So when we get the signal, or I go down there and say, are you ready? It's all right, Nathaniel should be here very soon, at least in half an hour's time. It's all good. So, Peiwei's car has arrived, and so she's preparing herself. So, just talk amongst yourself for a little minute, and when I get the nod, I'll give the nod to our wonderful pianist, and we'll start the wedding. So, just relax for a bit until we get the party's ready. Script, by the way. Just what you like. Thank you. Suspense is a wonderful thing. They prepared to be stunned from the bride comes in. And he gets up. She still wants to do it. So again, if you remain seated, and when the bridal party starts on the aisle, then I invite you to stand when the main person, the second main person, is coming out. are here to witness and celebrate the marriage of Pei-Wei Fu and Nathaniel Reuben Chapman. We gather in the presence of God and surround them with prayer as we share in their joy. Today, as Pei-Wei and Nathaniel commit their lives in love to each other, let us commit ourselves to love and support them, and so celebrate God's love for us all. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. God is love, and those who live in love live in God, and God lives in them. Let us raise our voices as we sing Amazing Grace. You'll find the words in the order of service. Gracious God, your generous love surrounds us, and everything we enjoy comes from you. In your great love, you have given us the gift of marriage. Bless Pei-Wei and Nathaniel as they pledge their lives to each other, that their love may continue to grow and be the true reflection of your love for us all, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Marriage is a gift of God and a means of grace. In the lifelong union of marriage, we can know the joy of God in whose image we are made, male and female. Marriage is founded in God's loving nature and in the covenant of love made with us in Christ. Husband and wife, in giving themselves to each other in love, reflect the love of Christ for his church. In Christian marriage, wife and husband are called to live together faithfully, and to love each other with respect, tenderness, and delight. The companionship and comfort of marriage enables the full expression of physical love between husband and wife. They share the life of a home and may be entrusted with the gift and care of children. They help to shape a society in which human dignity and happiness may flourish and abound. Marriage is a way of life that all people should honour. It is not to be entered into lightly or selfishly, but responsibly and in the love of God. Haywai and Nathaniel, you are now here to begin this way of life that God has created and Christ has blessed. Therefore, on this, their wedding day, we pray that they may fulfill God's purpose for the whole of their lives. You may sit down for a bit for 10 minutes, and you may sit down as well. Thank you. I'm going to invite Tim to come and bring our scripture reading from the Epistle of Colossians. Thanks, Tim. Excited, you've scrubbed up really well. Everyone's looking beautiful, including everyone in the congregation. This is probably arguably the most significant day of your lives, for you've doubtlessly dreamt of this day for many months, years, and you've most likely thoroughly prepared every single detail. And Haywai, when I first met you, I knew there would be every single detail. You've done a lot of work to prepare yourselves spiritually and emotionally for being married. Together we've talked very honestly and earnestly about marriage during your pre-marriage counselling. And so here we are, ready to make promises and vows. Before we get to that part of the journey, I have a question for you. When you step out of your wedding clothes later this evening, what are you going to put on? And you don't actually have to answer the question, by the way. We are talking metaphors here, everyone. How will you dress for a healthy and enriching marriage? What are you going to wear to ensure that yours will be an enduring and fulfilling marriage? The Apostle Paul, in his letter to the Colossians, make some suggestions for a healthy and sustainable marriage wardrobe, which we've heard in the reading. Firstly, according to Paul, you need to put on compassion. Now, compassion means suffering with. But for you, it's more appropriate for you to think in simple terms of to be there for each other through thick and thin. And you'll be thick and you'll be thin. Compassion is also an inner attitude you each have toward each other. The caring for and about the other's vulnerability and strengths, which will overflow into how you treat each other both privately and in the company of others. On top of compassion again, according to St. Paul, put on kindness. When you're clothed with kindness, you'll be seeking the other's good as you deal with each other's weaknesses and sore spots. Kindness is a garment that clothes us in times of stress and challenge. And there will be those times. For we grow when we are stretched and we're tested. There's another item of clothing that enriches a marriage: humility. If ever there was a place where pride, the need to be right, and the struggle to be in power, is actually the marriage. Lack of humility can lead to all kinds of struggle. Humility recognises the other's equal status and that each of you has needs and plans which are equally valid. Gentleness is another necessary garment for marriage. When you put on gentleness, the other can take off any self-defensiveness, wariness, fearfulness, and instead they and you then put on trust. And here's an absolutely necessary article of clothing for a marriage. Patience. Each of you will discover, if you haven't already, that the other has the capacity to annoy you from time to time. Please don't tell me you haven't, because I know you have. It doesn't matter what the issue is. Marriage takes patience. Patience requires humour and a spirit of live and let live. Another essential garment for a marriage is a spirit of forbearance and forgiveness. There's a lot that needs to be endured in a marriage, a lot that requires forbearance. It is a spirit of forgiveness that makes difficult things endurable and sometimes even erases them. Nowhere more in a marriage is love repeatedly having to say, "I'm sorry." And for those of you as old as me, the movie The Love Story said, "Love means never having to say you're sorry." They got it wrong. It does. It does include saying sorry. And we don't say sorry to get out of a tight spot. We say it because we know that in any other relationship, there is nothing that is so vulnerable and so easily hurt as a couple in marriage. And when the other has asked forgiveness, we need to have the grace to grasp it. Finally, the garment of love. In another one of Paul's letters to the Corinthians, he speaks to the people of Corinth about a love that is not simply a romantic notion, but a love that endures all things. In both Corinthians 13 and Colossians 3, Paul is clear about such love. Love, like your clothes, needs to be put on consciously every single day. This intentional practice will stand you in good stead as you grow together, weathering the inevitable storms life will throw at you, as well as the times of bliss and celebration. Nathaniel and Payway, the putting on of these essential articles of clothing will eventually become second nature to you, because you will not be alone in this marriage. Jesus, through his life, death, and resurrection, and his love for his church, has prepared the way for you. May you be aware of the presence of God in times of celebration and in times of great challenge. And may God bless you both today and in the many days, weeks, months and years ahead. I'm going to give you a Bible. And this Bible is a reminder of the commitments that you're going to be making to each other, but also of God's love for you both.
Mama.
In Christ alone, our hope is found. Let us stand or sit if it's more comfortable for you. Actually, no, I think I need to just sit with COVID. In Christ alone, the words are in your order of service. Hayway and Nathaniel. Do you believe that God has blessed and guided you and today called you into marriage? Nathaniel, will you give yourself to Hayway to be her husband, to live together in the covenant of marriage? Will you love her, comfort her, honour and protect her, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live? Hayway, will you give yourself to Nathaniel to be his wife, to live together in the covenant of marriage? Will you love him, comfort him, honour and protect him, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live? I'd like to invite Susan and Christopher to stand, please, and maybe come into the aisle. And I'm going to ask Marianne to come in, because Hayway's parents will also be responding to the questions I'm about to ask from Taiwan. Do you, Susan and Christopher, on behalf of your family, give your blessing to Hayway and Nathaniel and promise to support them in their marriage? Now, this is a challenge for me. Do you, Xiaomin and Shui-Wei, Shui-Kwa, there you go, my apologies, on behalf of your family, give your blessing to Hayway and Nathaniel and promise to support them in their marriage? We do. I'm echoing, I heard we do. Thank you, Susan and Christopher. And thank you. We're getting there. Gracious God, you are always faithful in your love for us. Look mercifully upon Hayway and Nathaniel, who have come seeking your blessing. Let your Holy Spirit rest upon them, so that with steadfast love they may honour the promises they make this day through Jesus Christ our Saviour. Amen. I'd like you to face each other, please, and hands apart for the time being. Nathaniel, would you like to take Hayway's hand? And after me, I, Nathaniel, in the presence of God, take you, Hayway, to be my wife. All that I am, I give to you. And all that I have, I share with you.
All that I have, I share with you.
Whatever the future holds.
Whatever the future holds.
I will love you and stand by you.
Love you and stand by you.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
This is my solemn vow.
This is my solemn vow.
Hayway, would you take me home? I, Hayway, in the presence of God, take you, Nathaniel, to be my husband. All that I am, I give to you. And all that I have, I share with you. Whatever the future holds, I will love you and stand by you. As long as we both shall live. This is my solemn vow.
This is my solemn vow.
And I believe we have rings. Junior. This is always the testing point, isn't it, for the attendants? Were you paying attention? Junior, would you place the rings on the book? Thank you. I'm very grateful because they're very different from each other. Rather than Nathaniel trying to, so it's all sorted now. There's always that concern, if the rings are the same size, are they going to go on their fingers? But it's absolutely fine. God of steadfast love, by your blessing, let these rings be to Paley and Nathaniel, symbols of the vows they've made today, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Nathaniel, as you place the ring on Paley's finger, you say, Paley, I give you this ring. As a sign of our marriage.
As a sign of our marriage.
And of the vows that we have made today.
And of the vows we have made today.
Nathaniel, I give you this ring.
As
a sign of our marriage.
As a sign of our marriage.
And of the vows we have made today. You can join both of your hands. Please join both of your hands. You may stand for this. Hold on a moment. No, hold on. Please stand. Before God, in the presence of us all, Paley and Nathaniel have made their solemn vows. They have confirmed their marriage by the joining of hands and by the giving and receiving of rings. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and the Holy Spirit, I therefore proclaim them, they are now husband and wife. Those whom God has joined together, no one must separate. You can get excited and applaud if you like. Eternal God, without your grace, no promise is sure. Strengthen Paley and Nathaniel with patience, kindness, gentleness, and all of the other gifts of the Holy Spirit, so that they may fulfill the vows they have made. Let their love for each other be a seal upon their hearts, a mantle around their shoulders, and a crown upon their heads. Bless them in their work and in their companionship, in their joys and in their sorrows. And finally, in your mercy, bring them with all your saints to their heavenly home. We ask this through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, God for ever and ever. Amen. You may stand. And here's the bit that every movie looks forward to. Nathaniel, you may kiss your bride, and Paley, you may kiss your husband. I'd invite the families to light the bridal candle. We light this candle as your marriage is blessed from the great candle which the church lights at Easter as a symbol of the risen Christ. We also light candles from it at baptisms as new Christians go out into the world bearing Christ. Your love is a sign of the victory of God's love over the divisions and disputes of humankind. May this candle remind you of this day, and the light of Christ be with you always. Rather than holding on to the rest of the service while you're signing it, I'll just put it in. I'd invite you, when you hear the words, "Lord, hear us," to respond with, "Lord, hear our prayer." So when you hear the words, "Lord, hear us," "Lord, hear our prayer." Let us pray. All grace comes from you, O God, the source of life and love. Bless your servants Payway and Nathaniel, that they may faithfully live together to the end of their lives. May they be patient and gentle, ready to trust each other and to face together the challenge of the future. Lord, hear us. Be with them in all their happiness and strengthen them in every time of trouble. Give Payway and Nathaniel grace when they hurt each other, to acknowledge their fault, to ask each other's forgiveness, and to know your mercy and grace. May your peace dwell in their home and be a sign of hope for peace in the world. May their home be a place of peace and love, warmth and welcoming of others. Lord, hear us. Through loving one another in Christ, may they be strengthened to love Christ and their neighbour. May they be creative in their daily work and find fulfilment in the life of their community. Lord, hear us. Grant Payway and Nathaniel grace to share their love and faith, that they may grow together as a loving family. Bless the parents and family of Payway and Nathaniel, that they may be united in love and friendship. Lord, hear us. And may all who witness these vows today find their lives strengthened and their relationships and commitments renewed. We offer these prayers in the name of Christ our Lord, who taught us to pray together, saying, "You will find the word of the Lord's Prayer in your name, in your order of service." Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. We are now going to sign the Lord's Day. So, listen to the beauty of the music that will be playing as we do so. I invite Junior and Cheryl to come as witnesses to the sign. is now my great privilege and delight to introduce you to Payway and Nathaniel Chapman. And the Spirit dance in the centre of your gathering. Amen.
Amen.
They are married. Would you please stand as we farewell them before the next part of this important day. Thank you.
I think I can handheld it.
Yeah.
Yeah. Lucky with that.